Hello, and welcome to the American Express Off the Court WNBA All-Star Roundtable here in Phoenix. I'm Swin Cash. Throughout the year, American Express has provided a platform for NBA players and legends to talk about their passions and also a little basketball. Now it's time to meet a legendary group of WNBA superstars. Quite a collection of championships, MVP awards, and I mean, their trophy case is filled with awards. But with us today, in no particular order, we have Diana Taurasi from the Phoenix Mercury, Maya Moore from the Minnesota Lynx, Candace Parker from the Los Angeles Sparks, and Tamika Catchings from the Indiana Fever. Welcome, ladies.
Good to be here.
Nice to be here. All-star. Multiple times. Yes, yes. Well, we're together here for All-Star Weekend. You guys are all ultra competitive, as I know, but this is also a celebration. What's your approach to this year's All-Star Weekend, Maya?
Well, my approach, just to enjoy it. You know, this is such a fun time for not only the fans, but the players. You know, we're always trying to compete, beat each other up, you know the scouting report, know her weaknesses, try to get in there. And here we're just relaxed. We're teammates, we're enjoying each other. I get to pass Candace the ball instead of trying to defend her and,
right.
You know, watch Diana do her thing or Tamika, so you're on the other side. But besides that, you know.
Left. I'm so unmatched. I know you're on
your side. What about you, Candace?
Well, I think this is definitely for the fans. You know, obviously, I've watched a lot of All-Star games just back at home before I was in the WNBA, and I think I was excited as a fan for everybody to be in the same place and, you know, to see your favorite players, and now to be here and to be a part of that, you know, it's really special.
And Kesh, what's this number? 8, 9, 10, 11? Ooh. What's this for you?
I don't know.
Multiple times, how do you approach it this weekend?
Just to have fun. You know, like the lady said, really it's just an opportunity to play with players that you probably won't get to play with on your actual team. So, you know, for that. And then for me, all the first, you know, the first timers. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's fun to see them and how excited they are to be here and just like wide-eyed, like, well, what do we do now? Where do we go?
Right.
You know, so it's really fun to be a part of their first time.
Yeah, well, you know, it's funny because I always love All-Star, but being here and then winning MVP, Candace, you won it last year, All-Star. I'm curious as to who's going to be trying to win MVP this year. Diana?
I'm trying to get an East Side win.
Oh, yeah.
Diana? We're right here in your backyard?
Probably not. I wouldn't bet on me, but you can. You know, it's just fun that the game's in Phoenix. You know, these fans are so loyal. I said they're probably the only group of fans that don't boo anyone, you know, because they have so much respect for Cash, for Maya, for Candace, for you. And I think it's special for the fans to be able to watch the best players in the world. So to me, I think that's the best part of the weekend so far.
Of course, of course. And we're right here in Diana's backyard in Phoenix. But the WNBA is in its 18th season. And some of you have been here for a lot of that. Not saying that we're old. I like to say season. Yes. But how does it feel to know that some of the rookies today were little girls looking up to you? How does that feel, D?
I mean, it's like Candace said, that was us 10 years ago, you know? And, you know, you come into this game and you see Shoney and Diggins and BG, all these young kids that, you know, one day it's going to be their league and, you know, they're going to take off with it. So it's pretty cool to be able to share the court with them and some time in the locker room with them. So.
And what about you, Tamika? Do you feel a responsibility as these younger players coming in and watch you when they were younger and now kind of teach them the ropes here?
Yeah, you know, just try to show them. I know, you know, it's not like we're in the beginning of our career, so we kind of make our way out. You know, just try to show them what this league is all about and what it stands for. And, you know, I know, I mean, like Candace said, just growing up and watching us, and now they're here. And so it's like, okay, you got to continue that legacy and keep this league alive and celebrate 18 years, but let's not stop anytime soon.
Absolutely. And Maya, you're one of the youngest here on the round table right now. Who did you admire? Who did you watch growing up?
Man, back in the earlier years, the Houston Comet reign, that dynasty, you know, Coop and Cheryl Swoops, Tina Thompson, Jeanette Arcane. The often forgotten Jeanette Arcane.
The fourth Beatle. They're
not the same without her. But I was a WNBA junkie. I grew up watching every game, wearing clothes, buying the gear. I was truly like a WNBA kid. So being here now is is amazing. I remember watching all these women, including yourself, in college.
Ooh,
mainly.
It make me feel so old.
In college. Because college was really exciting for, of course, the Tennessee-UConn rivalry and, you know,
and look at our panel
that.
Here. I mean, this wasn't done. It's pretty good.
It's a little Tennessee sandwich. Right?
good. Well, of course, we all were rookies at one point or another in our careers. But at what point in your WNBA career did it just click for you on the court, Candace? When did you step on the court to say, you know what, I know that there's greatness inside of me?
You know, I think it's a process. And I think that's what allows people to get better every year is when you don't think that you've ever, you know, arrived or you ever have gotten it, because then you have young bucks coming up that are ready to take your spot. So, you know, I think in terms of the speed of the game, it definitely got easier my second and third year, because you kind of get used to the speed, the physicality.
What about you, Dee? When did it click for you?
It really is a process. I mean, from your first year to your second year to the fifth year, to, you know, double-digit years for us. Like, you know, there's a different way to prepare for a game. There's things that you know you need to get done. When you were younger, you know, you could go play 40 minutes, feel good the next day. Now it's like, you have to take care of your body, make sure you're eating right, getting your rest. I mean, it's a different way of how it consumes your life to make sure you're ready to get on the court. So for me, it's changed drastically, really.
And what about you, Ketch? When did it click? And I know when you came in, you were out your first year as a rookie, so you had time to really actually look at things from the sideline before you actually played.
Yeah, and getting out there, having that first year definitely allowed me an opportunity to see what was going on first. And then coming out that second year, I was like, okay, you know, the speed of the game is still different. It's a lot different watching it on the sideline than when you're actually in it and thrown into it. But, you know, kind of like they said, takes a couple years, and even now, like as we've gotten older, more seasoned, you know, just like the pregame routine. Yeah. I mean, I used to get to the gym literally like my first probably 10 years.
Five minutes before practice
no,
starts.
Like I would get to the gym even before games like an hour, and I would work out hard. And so, you know, like I would go hard and then play the game. And now it's kind of like, okay, you know, you get out there, get your shots up, 10, 15 minutes, go sit down.
Yeah. I like that.
Rub my shoulders, you know, about minutes. Yeah.
minutes.
You have to.
I love that D, boop, boop, boop. Yeah. And then I go just sit down.
That's a nice little place in your mind.
Efficiency. You know, that's what I watched, you know, my first few years with like Taj and some of the older players we have. Seasoned players that we have, of just their efficiency and how they go about their business and everything, whether that's, you know, nutrition or their warm up. You know, I like to watch and study and see, and that's why I think in my fourth year I found kind of a nice sweet spot, because I've been paying attention to these vets and how they do things, and hopefully will save me some early pain or lessons that I don't have to learn the hard way.
Absolutely. Hear that, younger players out there? Make sure you're paying attention to your vets and taking care of things, and get as efficient as Maya has, because she is out there balling right now. Everyone here knows how hard it is, you know, to win a championship. Three of you have won WNBA titles. Talk to me about what it takes to win a championship. What's that special ingredient you need to win a championship? We'll start with you, Dee.
Oh, boy. I mean, there's so many factors. Staying healthy, making sure you have the right amount of right players, making sure that you're so locked in every single day and you're so worried about the moment that you don't even think about winning a championship. And that's hard to do, especially when you have won one. And to get 11 people on the same page is so hard. That's why it's so hard to win a championship.
Absolutely. And I love what you were saying, Dee, about is just staying in the moment and then moving from there. Ketch, a lot of times people think it's about talent. You won a championship with the team, and if you look at it from top to bottom with the roster, people may not say you had the most talent, but what did it take for your team to actually win?
Being in the moment. You know, we lost two key people that played quality minutes for us during the season, Katie Douglas, Jeanette Poland, and then, you know, we're going against Minnesota, who's loaded from top to bottom. But really it was about, like, lock in, be here for the moment. Don't worry about who's going in. Don't worry about who's playing. Just everybody come. And whenever you get out there, you just play and play your heart out. And that, like, literally every single person that got on the court played their heart out. And at the end, it was just like, you're so tired. You're so excited, but you're so tired. And it's just like, wow, it's like, this real life, like kind of surreal.
Great feeling.
Mm-hmm. And Maya, what about you? What did you learn from the first one to help you when you got to the second one?
Just the amount of preparation. The amount of preparation consistently throughout the year. And you can't waste any moment. You can't take anything for granted. If there's something earlier on in the season you know you need to take care of, it's gonna catch you mm-hmm. at the end. And that's what happens. You know, there's no point in the finals where you're not gonna be exposed because the other team, they've been studying you, they've been studying you, they've been ready. So just having that ultimate focus every single day. And like Diana said, you gotta have the right people with the right attitude, the right toughness, the right leadership that are gonna sacrifice and not let their egos or pride get in the way at any moment, because chemistry is huge. Mm-hmm. Chemistry is so important to a championship team. You gotta have selfless people be the majority. If you want to have a chance.
Absolutely. And Candace, I want to let you jump in here because I know that you're hungry and you're still pursuing that championship. So what do you think it'll take for you really to get over the hump with your team?
Well, I think, like all of them said, just being in the moment. You know, obviously, I think the thing I've learned the most is that every possession matters. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, a lot of the games that we've lost in the playoffs have come down to like one or two possessions or one-point games and things like that. And you think that earlier possessions in the game, you know, aren't a factor when it is. And so mm-hmm. I think just from watching playoffs in the WNBA and then as well as the NBA, I mean, it's important.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So no possessions off, no days off if you want to be holding that trophy at the end. Mm-hmm. All right. So one other thing about basketball before we move on to off the court is leadership, because I feel all four of you are leaders and you lead in different ways because I've been on teams with you. Just real quickly, Ketch, give me something about leadership. What's it take to have great leadership?
Respect. Your players, your teammates have to respect you. Mm-hmm. You got to talk the talk and be able to walk the walk.
Absolutely. D?
For sure. I mean, you got to show up every single day ready to work. You know, we always talk about leaders always obviously being in the forefront, but as a leader, sometimes you need to take a step back. Because mm-hmm. You're only as strong as the next person on the team. And that leadership has to trickle down, and that responsibility has to be on everyone's shoulder. Mm-hmm. So sometimes taking a step back, too.
Absolutely. And Candace?
I think sometimes people mistake leadership for being, like, the most vocal. Mm-hmm. But to me, it's just about your actions. Like, sometimes when, you know, teammates may look to you to be doing things that they know they should be doing. Mm-hmm. Or, you know, it's not always being out up front. It's sometimes pulling a teammate aside and telling them what they need to hear. Or things like that. So I think that's important.
Maya? Yeah.
Absolutely what these ladies have been saying. I'd probably say somebody who is invested in someone who puts themselves out there. Mm-hmm. I know if I have a teammate that says, you know, I made that mistake. Mm-hmm. I owned up to it. And they put themselves out there. They don't always try to show that they're perfect. They're vulnerable, but they're also strong, because they know they have to trust their team. When they show that they trust you, you want to do everything you can for that leader. So that's something that you know, I've come to value in a leader is that kind of vulnerability yet toughness at the same time. It's kind of a cool dynamic to have.
Yeah. Well, you ladies are not only dropping dimes, they are also dropping that knowledge. So I hope you guys are paying attention. But let's loosen it up a little bit right now. Okay, time to put you guys on the spot. I want to mix and match your skill sets. All right. So, Candace, if you could take one skill from Diana, what would it be?
I would say I would take her court vision. I think the thing that people underestimate, if they do underestimate anything about Dee, just playing with her as a teammate, she has the best court vision.
Absolutely.
I mean, she's like the best passer, you know, I've ever played with.
And if you don't
with.
Put your hands up, something's
going to
hit you.
You will get hit in the face.
We already know
you
that,
will get
right?
hit in the face. She doesn't like turnovers. She better put your hand up. No, but I would take that for sure.
Okay, okay. Mm-hmm. And D, yeah. What would you take from Maya?
Maya's, oh, man. Maya is, I mean, I've never been to war, but I feel like it would be like a siege. When you're in the game against Maya, it just like comes pouring down on you from every angle, and you're just like, can this end already? I mean, she just, everything.
Everything.
At the highest level.
Nah, it's
I'd take it all. I don't want just one thing. I want the three. I want the post game. I want the hands.
You want the stretch,
I want the strength. I want it all. So I'm taking it all, Maya. Sorry.
Leaving you with nothing, Maya.
You still have plenty left over. Sure.
Okay. It's Tamika. What would you take from Candace?
Candace, I would definitely take just her all-around game. You know, like you're an all-around player. I mean, we just got got beat by them, but you know, like literally when she turns it on, it's just like it's unstoppable. That unstoppable, just like I don't know what it is, you know, like that switch that you have in you. And if you had that for 40 minutes, I could take that from you and I could do something. But no, I mean, seriously, like you're inside, outside, everything that you can do, you're just unstoppable.
Mm-hmm. And Maya, what'd you take from Tamika?
Her tenacity, it's on another level. I don't think there's anybody else over her career who's played with that much consistent tenacity of when she steps on the court, there's an automatic shift. There's no question, especially defensively. Somebody who can be good offensive. You see a lot of good offensive players, but someone who's dominated for, you know, as long as I can remember on both ends, it's unheard of, so it's not talked about enough, and yeah. I would bottle that up, drink it, halftime, get the rest, post game recover.
So she got, you got all of that, all the whole energy thing is coming from you. Okay, so we got the court vision, we got tenacity, we got the all over you. And then we got the all-around game. You're creating a monster, ladies. You're creating a monster. That's great. That's all good stuff on the court. But let's take it off the court for a minute. Tell me what's your taste in music. I want to know what's on your playlist right now. And we have a variety of music up here. And I want y'all to be honest because I already know. But I think that the fans would love to know what's on your playlist right now. We'll start with you, Tamika.
I do Christian music. So I'm all about, right now, Bizzle. I like Bizzle Lecrae, Anthony Evans. I went to school with him, so I listen to his music. J Moss, one of my favorites. List goes on and on.
Candace? Well, we know you're a huge Young Candace fan. She's thrown up the rock, y'all. Hey, what's on your playlist, Candace? What's on your playlist?
I'm a huge Jay-Z fan, so anything Jay-Z all the time. Uh-huh. I'm kind of Adele, if I want to slow it down type thing, but it's probably throw some Beyonce in there, but yeah, kind of keep it Jay-Z. Mm-hmm. Kind of, yeah, everything's Jay-Z.
Okay, Maya, what about you?
I like Tamika's flavor as well. Artist named Molly Music. You got to just go. I can't even talk about it, but it's a great kind of mix of like R&B, hip hop, gospel, style. I like Lecrae as well. Some Hillsong in there. But I just purchased the Molly Music new album. Gotta get it. Yeah. It's called Molly Is. I don't know the man, but dropping it for you right now, Molly.
Okay, go cop that then. All right, so y'all giving me a little sample. You wanna give us a little sample of it, Maya?
I'm not ready for all that.
No, we're not ready.
Okay, we'll come back to Maya doing things for us. Moving on, ladies. So much has changed since you all entered the league, especially how we stay in touch with our fans. And you know I'm talking about social media, because we're all over it. But who would you say is a must follow on Twitter and Instagram?
Justin Bieber.
Yeah. We're gonna start over here. Who's a must follow?
I don't know.
D, you got one?
I don't do social media.
She does. There we go.
No, I don't. I don't. That's okay. Not me. It's my agent.
I think LeBron. WNBA. LeBron's a good follow.
Yeah?
Like LeBron's.
Okay,
a good
does anybody follow Kevin Hart? He's hilarious.
I follow Kevin Hart. LeBron is good though because I love
good.
The family.
And like, he does, like family
him and
D
Wade. I like them.
Okay.
Gabrielle Union. She's a good one.
I'm not as much on the social media social as media. Well. I have social media binges.
Oh. Where you just go in and
I just go in 8, 9, 7, 6, 5.
And then you pull it back
then
out.
And it's 2 weeks, nothing.
Okay.
And
you're out.
Uh-oh. And then just get them. Pull out.
No. Yeah, mine does do that.
But yeah, I follow different musicians or nutrition. It's a good way to get some nutrition motivation and info, quick.
Mango fit. I am like a social media, like,
are you a lurker?
I take your phone. I'll take your phone. I'll be like, yeah, I would take Candace's phone. I'd be like, let me get this for like 2 hours.
So, yeah. D, are you the person on social media that has the egg and has, like, you're following everybody, but you're not really posting anything? So, are you a lurker?
No, I'm not a lurker.
She's a taker.
I'm not a lurker.
Okay.
Lurking.
All right, so we're going to move on. In basketball, we always talk about your go-to moves. Everybody has a go-to move. But here's something I want to know. Who has a go-to pregame meal? What are you eating pregame? Mikey, I mean, Tamika, because we know you eat everything.
I have chicken, mashed potatoes, and broccoli.
Deep.
Chicken, brown rice, veggies.
Absolutely. Maya?
I love pasta, but if it's a morning game, I make these mean whole wheat chocolate chip pancakes. Girl.
With syrup?
Nap time, wake up, boom.
Good.
With syrup?
With syrup?
Mm-hmm, pure maple syrup.
Energy.
Candace?
I kind of switch it up. Salmon. I like pasta, like seafood, shrimp, stuff like that. But I got into juicing, so I'm real big on juicing now.
Dang.
Before we wrap it up here, tell us something, I guess, about yourself. This will tell us a lot about you. If you're a morning person or if you're a night person. D, you're a morning person or a night person?
I'm a night into morning person.
A night into morning. I like that transition, D. Meek.
Morning.
Morning. Definitely morning. Go to bed early?
Yeah.
Yes. Maya.
I'm a night owl.
Night owl.
I have to be very disciplined to make myself go to bed at a reasonable hour.
Turn all the lights and everything off?
Yeah, I got to turn off the technology and just kind of chill out. Otherwise, I'll be up just
getting stuff. Candace? The one with the baby.
I used to be a night owl. I used to sleep in till like 11 o'clock. And then when I had Layla, all that changed. So actually she does sleep in a little bit, but you know, I've become a morning person.
Thanks to all of you for hanging out with me today, ladies. Fans, you can follow these ladies on Twitter. Tamika is Catching24. Maya is More Maya. Candace is Candace_Parker, and Diana, who's going to be more social on social media, is Diana Taurasi. And of course, I'm Swin Cash. Also, be on the lookout for the WNBA Everyday Moments presented by American Express, featuring none other than Candace Parker and myself. And a reminder to check out NBA.com/off the court for lots more great content with your favorite players. Ladies, thanks again for coming out with me. Have some fun this All-Star weekend. Stay healthy, and good luck the rest of the season. When you play the Liberty. I'm Swin Cash. Thanks for joining us for today's American Express WNBA All-Star Roundtable.